welcome back. Joining us now to answer your pet questions is Dr. Kim Hammond. Of course, that wasn't Kim. Now here's Kim. So Kim, tell us about your friend.
This is like a little snowball. This is a schnoodle. Schnoodle. Can't eat it, but he can play with it. Yeah, his name is Teddy. And, you know, it's got a little rat named T-Bear. T-Bear. T-Bear.
All right.
This is just a sweetheart. You know, it's just they're just some great animals out there, and this is one of the ones.
All right. And one that's very friendly and a lot of fun.
Totally friendly and really a great dog, makes a really fabulous dog. I like schnoodles.
Oh, well, why don't we get to our questions?
Right.
How do you know when your puppy has worms? That's the first question.
Okay, so look, all puppies have worms. Just sort of use that as a... In fact, Teddy had worms. That's the reason Teddy came to see us originally, is because Teddy was not doing really well. It's just one of those natural phenomena. And if they don't have worms, they can get worms. So you just go to your veterinarian, you bring a fecal sample, they take care of it, and don't be surprised if it just recurs. You just take care of it.
Okay. All right, our next question. I have a 20-week-old boxer puppy and was wondering how old you recommend her getting spayed. Also, are there 5-month boosters required?
Well, you know, the discussion about, let me talk about the boosters first. The discussion about vaccines, there is a specific scientific method for giving vaccines. And depending on how many shots your dog has had, it may or may not need shots at that time. It's not a specific 5-month vaccine. So your veterinarian will advise you about that. And in terms of getting spayed, you know, we like spaying them at about that time, about 5-6 months. It's a good time to get spayed. So I would say go to your veterinarian and get it done. The other interesting thing is there's real price differentials about spaying animals. And you can get your animal spayed for as low as $50.
Depending on where you go.
Exactly. So don't spend $300 or $400 getting your animal spayed.
Okay. And Teddy's getting a little restless here.
Yeah.
Just a little bit.
Okay. Yeah, he likes
all
to play.
All right. And our 5-year-old Irish setter has constant ear infections. Do you have any reasons why, and what can be done about this?
All right, so constant ear infection, we may not have knocked it out the first time, so go to a veterinarian that understands how to culture whatever that bug is in the ear and then treat it accordingly. But then you have to think about lifestyles. You know, dogs that swim or they get a lot of baths suddenly are re-inoculating their ear and they're getting, you know, they're getting ear infections.
All right.
Teddy likes you, man.
Teddy's ready to get down.
Teddy just wants a little pet.
Hey, Teddy, how you doing? How you doing, Teddy?
He just loves
Teddy's
little
barrier. Let's go play. Let's try to get out of here now.
Yeah. He says, I don't know. I don't want the news.
Okay. All right. Well, Dr. Kim,
all right, buddy.
Dealing with Teddy now, you talked about how Teddy first started with worms and things like that.
Yeah.
And you talked about the other shots. As you move into, how do you know exactly when it is time for Teddy to get other shots and things like that?
Teddy, at about 2, 3, and 4 months of age, Teddy gets shots. And then it's yearly or every 3 years thereafter.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Dr. Kim Hammond, thank you.
All right.